So see, over here, they are asking you for the ray diagram of the convex. Okay, so you will make a rough diagram, no need to do. Okay. At infinity, so when your position of the object is at infinity, okay? So your position of the image will be at focus. This is what you have to learn. Plus, what will be the size of the image? See, for example, you are standing here, right? So this is the object. You are the object right now. But what is the position of the image? That is whatever image will be formed. Okay. So it will be point size. And what will be the nature? Real and inverted. So you can feel it like this. For example, rays are coming from infinity. As I told you, whenever they are parallel, they will touch it and they will come here. Right. So they are making the point at this F2. Okay. Now beyond C1. When it is beyond C1, like see, this is C. I hope you can see my screen. C1. So it is here. Over there, first of all, it was infinity. You don't know where the position is, but here now it is here. So when it will pass from here, then your image will be forming between F2 and C2 here. Clear? And it will be diminished and real and inverted. Yeah. Then at C1. Now your image is at C1. So you first infinity, then beyond C.
I'm not able to hear you clearly because there's drilling going on.
Okay. So any solution for that?
I don't know what to do. Should you speak or should we just take a break?
Okay. So how much time it will take? Okay. What you can do till then, you can write it down. Okay. Then I'll explain. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
No need to draw this. Okay. Just write these three. Just make a table. Position of our object, position of the image, relative size, and the nature.
Okay, ma'am. mom done. And my drilling is also done.
Okay. You have not written this. Complete this, then I'll discuss, okay? Last.
Oh, okay. Yes, I'm done.
Okay, so let's just discuss. So we were discussing this one. So when it will be at C, then it will be at C2. Like when you have this, you have to learn. Okay, so now it will be at C2. Then when it is in between F1 and C1, this F1 and C1, then your image will be beyond C2, this one. And at F1, this one, then your image will be at infinity. Then when it is between F1 and 0, then over here, your image will be here. One on the same side of the lens of the object. Clear? Till here, it will come. Getting the point?
Yes, ma'am.
So this you have to learn, okay? Because if I'll ask you that when your image is at F1, like the object, where your image will be formed, so you should remember it. Okay, and also what will be the shape, like size as well as the it will be real inverted or virtual erect. You have to learn that. Now it is basically concave. In concave, you have only two things, like two cases. Okay, first case is when it is at infinity, and other case when anywhere between infinity and zero. Okay, O means, so it can, whether you put it here, 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 anywhere, you will get same thing. Clear?
Yes. Mom, none.
Okay. Now coming to the next thing, which we are going to do is this. I. Okay. So over there, this is a very important topic, which is your I. I think in maths, we have to start with playing with numbers, right, sir?
Mom, to be honest, just leave that chapter because that is too easy. We'll just start with mensuration.
Okay. Okay. Great. Okay. But I will take test for that.
Mom, take test.
Okay, so that I will get a surety that you know that. Okay.
Yes.
I will take your test on Saturday.
Okay.
Okay. So Saturday I'll take your test. What I will do, I think, I don't know whether we have off on New Year. You have any plans for New Year?
No, I'll just celebrate my birthday and that's it.
Okay, so you have your birthday on 31st or 1st?
First.
Okay, happy New Year and a happy birthday. Okay, so that means you can give test, right? So that will be the special, you can say special celebration that you are giving test. So I will keep your two tests. What is your 31st and what is your 1st?
Okay.
Okay. So you can tell me, like, for light chapter, you want to give it around 31st or you want to give it around 1st? It's according to you.
Or the
light. And on 1st, you'll give the playing with number. Right?
Yes.
Okay. So now, human eye. Human eye, you have basically these are the parts of it. So first of all, you should learn the parts. So first is this optic nerve. It carries the impulse received from the retina to the brain. Right? Whatever you are getting it, that pulse is going to catch it and it will bring it to the brain. Okay, this is what you saw. Blind spot, no sensory cells, so no vision is possible at this spot. So overhead, there are no sensors. So until and unless you don't have sensors, you cannot see anything. So there is nothing to see. Then ciliary muscles, it is basically hold the eye lens in a place and contract to increase the thickness of the lens and expands to make it thin. Okay. Then eyelid to protect the eye from the physical harm. Then the pupil, the hole in the middle of the iris, through which light enters the eye. So through pupil only our light enters. And iris, colored muscle behind the cornea, which controls the amount of light. So over here, through pupil it is entering, but this iris controls how much amount of light will be entering in your eyes. Okay. Then cornea, basically the exposed part of the eye that is transparent. Okay. Then eye lenses, clear convex lens. Sometimes you get a one marker. In our eye, we have convex lens or the concave lens. Okay, so you should remember that it is always a convex lens. And the light is focused by the lens on the retina. Yeah, so these are the, you will write human eye and all the parts you will write. Okay?
Yes, ma'am. I'm done reading.
Okay, so now coming to next question, which is how images are being formed on the eye lenses. Okay, this is their actual question. So for example, this is the apple. You can see it, and from this muscle, it will go, and in your brain, you form the image, right? So the eye lens forms an inverted image on the retina. The optic nerves send electrical impulse to the brain, which processes the information and perceives the image as erect. Okay, so this is how. And there are two things. One is rods and cones in the retina. Okay, so the retina has two types of nerve cells. One is rod, one is cones. Because of this, only the image is being possible, whichever you see, whatever you see. So rods are the sensitive to light, dim light. They are useful to the night vision. Cones are sensitive to the bright light and they are used to see colors. Okay, so you will first write image formation by the eye lens and then you will write rods and cones in the retina.
I'm done.
Okay, so now coming to the next one, which is basically the last portion. Okay, so these are the things you will quick, you have already written everything about it. Okay, ray diagram, reflection, iris, you already know everything, right? So now we'll be starting with the question answer. I'm giving you 5 minutes. You can quickly revise whatever we have done in this chapter. And if you are facing any difficulty, you can just let me know. Okay.
Okay. No, ma'am, there are no doubts.
Okay, sir, so let's just start with the question answer. Just give me 1 minute. Okay, so can you see my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now the first question is, suppose you are in a dark room. Can you see an object in the room? Can you see object outside the room? Explain. So we can see object when the light is reflected from them enters our eyes. In a dark room, there is no light that is reflected from any object. So thus, we cannot see object in the dark room. As there is light present outside the room, the reflected light from the object will reach our eyes, and thus we will be able to see the object outside the room. So you cannot see object inside the room, but you can see objects which are outside the room. Clear?
Yes, ma'am. Mom, done.
Okay, sir. So after this, now differentiate between regular and diffuse reflection. Does diffuse reflection mean the failure of law of reflection? So see, regular reflection and diffuse reflection. Regular reflection takes place on the regular or a smooth surface. Diffuse reflection takes place on the irregular or uneven surface. In regular reflection, for parallel incident ray, the reflected ray are parallel to each other. In diffuse reflection, for parallel incident ray, the reflected rays are not parallel. So you have to remember, over here they are parallel. You can see it is coming here, going back, coming here, going back. But here they are like reverse, coming back, going back, whatever they are doing, right? Regular reflection, in the case of regular reflection, an image can be obtained. In the case of diffuse reflection, the image cannot be obtained, as the reflected rays for the parallel incident ray are in the random direction. So over here, you cannot form an image because they are not in the parallel direction. Here, you can form an image. Clear?
Yes.